This is my 36th year, so I've been there since it was almost a new building, it seems like.
I started in Summerfield August 23rd, 1979.
I'm completing my 38th year in the business school.
I began teaching in spring of 2009.
I've been with the School of Business for 17 years.
I was a student in Summerfield since 1978.
I arrived here in 1976.
Summerfield used to be the computer center for the university.
That was before I was there and they had a bomb.
And that was done during the Vietnam War. And you can still see some of that structural damage if you look in that hallway as you walk out that south door on the first floor.
Summerfield Hall didn't have a south side. The wall was entirely glass exposed to the southern sun. So in the summer, I can remember it was like an oven, being in an oven.
After I graduated and started my first job, I came back to help that company interview. So this was a very, very sunny fall day, so I was dressed appropriately for the fall. It was hot, the sun was beating in, and it was like a sauna in that room. And I picked up the University Daily Kansan to read it, and I was yawning, I was tired because of all this heat that was generated. And so I put down the paper and I rubbed my face. And oh my gosh, I was just trying to keep awake. So the first student came in and they kind of looked at me, averted their eyes. And nobody would talk to me. They just wouldn't even look at my face. And I thought, what is going on? The fourth student came in, looks me square in the eyes and said, I think you need to go into the restroom and wash your face. I went to the bathroom. I had ink all over my face like war paint.
And people would just absolutely cook in there. But one thing on our floor is we only had one restroom.
One semester it was a women's room, and one semester it was a men's room.
One afternoon when I went into the stall and sitting there and thinking, this is really a lot cleaner than I'm used to, and it smells a lot better. And I got to looking around more and more, and I realized that there were things there that I didn't normally see. And it dawned on me what had happened and where I was. And so, now I'm kind of feeling trapped.
I remember that we were up in 502, which is where we have all of our assembly meetings, and one of the faculty members walked in a little bit late and sat in one of those chairs, in their fixed chairs, and it literally just fell off the stanchion that it was on, and he landed on the floor. So
at least once a semester I would see a kid disappear under the desk because the chair would break in the middle of class. It was at that point I decided maybe I should take CPR.
So I came back from lunch and people were emptying my offices. Apparently a pipe had burst right above my computer and my printer. So there was a couple of inches of water on the floor. My checkbook was floating in the pool.
I was sitting in my office and the ceiling started to leak. And it started to leak on top of a file cabinet, and I grabbed this umbrella and was holding it over the file cabinet. There had been a leak in a pipe in the ceiling sometime in the past. They had just wrapped the leak in duct tape and somehow jerry-rigged a pan underneath the leak. The leak apparently had gotten worse and it filled up the pan and it started running over onto my file cabinet.
I used to joke that I was allergic to work because whenever I would leave I would feel better. And about a year ago we had a pretty major leak in my office and the office next door to mine. And so they ripped out the whole ceiling, and it turns out I literally was allergic to work because there was a water pipe running over my head, basically, that was just filled with mold and a rotting pipe. And I would leave and I would think, wow, I can breathe. How did that happen? And it was because there was a bunch of mold above me all day.
People hook up their little electric heaters and we'll trip a breaker.
We all have space heaters in our offices. They're all hidden.
If you try to use the microwave, you have to yell across the office to make sure nobody else is running anything in their office. We actually have a note on the microwave to remind us.
Sometimes those little mishaps or the frustrations when it's freezing or it's so hot that you can't bear it are just kind of part of our story. And I have to say that I will miss it. It's home, and the people that we work with are family.
And you can't help but develop affection for a place where you've been for so long.
And I have often thought about walking out of Summerfield Hall for the last time. It's a pretty powerful feeling that you have, because I've been in there since 1976.
It's been a formative part of my life.
It's part of all its quirks. I think it's been a home.
Ultimately, at the end of the day, we've had a facility that leaves some things to be desired, but we're providing an outstanding educational experience.
And I'm looking forward to having the students want to stick around.
There's an arms race among business schools for top talent. We even lose the occasional student to Missouri. Can you think of anything worse? Instead of the student and family being distracted by how homely Summerfield is, they're going to say, obviously my son or daughter is going to get a first-rate business education.
We have an engaged student body and an engaged leadership within the business school, and CapFed Hall will just simply provide an infrastructure to realize a more professional set of options for our students.
Saying goodbye to Summerfield is a mixed blessing for me, and the analogy that occurs to me off the top of my head, I remember when I had an abscessed tooth removed not too long ago, and it was a tooth that had served me very well for decades and decades. And I hated to see it go, but boy, do I like my new bridge.
Summerfield, I will miss you. You've been a great place to be, and you've been my home.
How do you say goodbye to something that wasn't that meaningful to begin with, do you?
I've certainly enjoyed my years in Summerfield Hall.
Oh, I'm kind of getting emotional. Summerfield has been a less than ideal space, but it's also been the place that I've grown professionally. And
I spent many good years in Summerfield.
I've had a good 38 years of Summerfield Hall. I don't think I'll ever get over it.
I might start crying. Okay, I met my husband in Summerfield. I'm glad that Prakash and I are both moving to the new business school building together.
Goodbye, Summerfield.
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 Goodbye, Summerfield. I'll miss you.